Hey, what's up, y'all? So today I'm gonna be doing a quick video on how to make a can't think of the name, bottle rig, a jug rig, as more formally known. I'm gonna show you two different ways for bigger bottles, smaller bottles. I only have a small bottle with me, so I can't show the bigger bottle way. But I will explain that, and then if you're using different types of jugs, I'll explain how to modify it to make it better, whatnot. So let's start out. What we'd be using today is just this big bottle, big cola. It's some Mexican drink. It's, you know, just a small bottle. Has the little increase thing right there, which is nice. And then, for the purpose of y'all being able to see better, I don't know if y'all can really see that better, but I'm going to be using this black string here, so that maybe y'all can see it better. So basically, just what you're going to do, it's really simple, is where that little indent is, kind of goes, dents, and then comes back out. You're just going to tie your string around there. Real quickly, you can do your normal fisherman knot if you want, if you have a favorite knot that you like to tie stuff on with more. You can do that. For now, I'm just going to do a simple little knot here. Like that. Alright. And so, basically, as you can see, there's this little black line. You'll have the hook sitting right here if you bait on it. Let me see if I can get all this in the video. There we go. Alright, so you just stick that in the water. Make sure that's tied on really tight. And the bottle will just float right there on the surface of the water. Kind of like that. Whenever you get a fish, it'll pull, obviously, and it'll kind of bob your bottle. Some fish will kind of carry it away. You can, if you want, you can secure it to a log or something so that they can't carry it away. Or if you're going to set up a couple of them in a small area and be able to watch them closely, then you can just let the fish carry it. When you have a fish on, you just go over there, grab the bottle, lift it out of the water, take the fish off, rebait it, and you can throw it back in. Now, if your bottle, obviously not all bottles have that little dent right there. If you have like a bigger 2-liter bottle or something, probably won't have that. So what you can do is you can either tie it on really tight and hope it stays, but the better thing to do is just at the very top of the bottle, put a little hole going through, and then just run your string along there and tie it. And try to keep that out of the water, because obviously you don't want your bottle filling with water and sinking. So just make sure if you do use a bigger bottle, make sure that your hole isn't going to take in water or anything, because you don't want that, obviously. Small bottles like this, I wouldn't really suggest unless that I would use this for more bait fish kind of thing. I mean, if you get a 5-pound bass, I doubt this is really going to do too much for the keep it above. Doubt this is really going to stay above water too much. Right now, from jugs, like if you have a milk jug or something with the handle, then if you want, you can tie your string onto that handle, and it'll stay there a little bit better. For these bottles, if tying it around there doesn't work, it should. If you tie it pretty strongly, it shouldn't really be able to go up and over that. But you can do the same thing. You just run a hole kind of through the top and feed your string through. But if you have jugs or something like that with a handle, then you can just tie it onto the handle. Or you can try making a hole in the jug. It may or may not work as well as a bottle. But you can try that if you want to. All right, now we got that out of the way. We're going to do a review for today, and I don't have it with me, unfortunately, today. It's back. It's not here today, but I'm going to be doing a review on the Gator Pro machete. Right there, that's my newest machete. As you can see, it has a little hook. It's not that long, but it works amazingly. The grip is really, really nice on that little string right there. You see that, it doesn't really work too well. It just kind of gets in my way. It's gone now, actually, kind of a bit broke. But it's not really that important anyway. But it has a super nice grip that fits my hand perfectly. And if my hand gets all sweaty, it doesn't really matter. The rubber grip is grippy enough that my hand will stick there. And then the hook is, it's fairly dull, but I like it a lot for catching vines and pulling them out, or just trying to like hook it onto something. I've climbed a couple of trees with it by hooking it onto a branch and pulling myself up and whatnot. It works decently well for that. You just want to make sure that you're not going to cut down the branch. So it's a great little machete. I got mine for $20. It was a deal at Dick's Sporting Goods. I got mine for $20, and it came with that and a knife that I gave to one of my friends. But they were both really nice. The knife I dunked into salt water for like 30 minutes, came back out, and you could barely tell except for the fact that it was wet. So they're both really, really nice products. I would definitely, if you're looking for a new machete, I would definitely recommend that one. If you want a longer one, they have the Gator, which is 18 inches. My brother has that one with the saw in the back. And then if you want, Ngerba also has another shorter one. It's a Gator Junior, I think. It's like basically a short version of the long one. Either three of those, I've owned all three of them. They're all great products. They work amazingly, do the job perfectly. I still own the Gator Pro, or the Gator Pro I still own, the Gator Junior I still own. I don't know what happened to the bigger Gator, but that's not important. So they're both all great products. If you're looking for a new machete, either one of those is great. And I do believe that is it, so I will see y'all next time. Bye.